Hey, how you doing? I'm Pastor Cat. This is your weekly encouragement. And for your weekly encouragement this week, I have a passage out of the book of Romans. One that I'm fairly interested in, actually, and has a lot to do with how you and I deal with other people in our lives, especially other people that are believers who are attempting to follow Christ. Now, Paul is typically thought of as being one of those guys in the New Testament who can come off a little harsh. He talks a lot about theology and a lot of kind of black and white sort of concepts can really turn you off. But I think when we really look at the words he said, there's a ton of encouragement to be found. Our passage today is about 7 verses long, starting at verse 1, chapter 15 of the book of Romans. And it says this: "Now we who are strong ought to bear the weakness of those without strength, and not just please ourselves. Each of us is to please his neighbor for his good, to his edification. For even Christ didn't please himself. But as it's written, the reproaches of those who reproached you fell on me. For whatever was written in earlier times was written for instruction, so that through perseverance, the encouragement of the scriptures, we might have hope." The reason I want to bring this up is oftentimes if you are an older believer in Christ and a young believer comes alongside and you feel like you're fairly strong in the faith and you want to encourage, you want to bless them and help them along on their journey to become the best believer they possibly can, the most Christ-like possible, it's easy for me to take my experience and possibly things that I've already figured out in my life and assume that they figure that out and either look down on them because they haven't or kind of hit them over the head with the Bible because they're not exactly where I am. Paul here wants to implore us in the fact that the knowledge that we have is not just to please us, but actually all those around us. And we really should not be hitting others over the head. If Christ wasn't out to please himself, then how in the world can I? Now he's going to continue. It gets even better. I promise. Stick with me. It says, "For whatever was written in earlier times was written for instruction, so that through perseverance, the encouragement of the scriptures, we might have hope." Now here we go. "Now may the God who gives perseverance and encouragement grant you to be of the same mind with one another, according to Christ Jesus, so with one accord you may with one voice glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore accept one another, just as Christ also accepted us to the glory of God." Now, there's a couple things here. One, it talks about believers being all in one accord, and the obvious joke is that it's not that accord. It's actually being of the same mind, going in the same direction. We in the church specifically can bash other people in the church because they don't do the thing that I want by saying, "You're not of one accord with us. You must get on board. We must all be going the same way," right? Put in your own sports metaphor right there. However, the encouragement Paul gives us is that if Christ could accept us and put us in front of the Father as holy and righteous through him, how much more should we accept one another? So my encouragement to you this week and to myself is to pick up, help, implore the younger believers around you to strengthen the entire body of Christ, not for my good pleasure, but for the Father's good pleasure through us in one accord. It is Easter season, and I have mentioned that once before. So this Easter, when you bring that person along with you to whatever your local congregation is doing for the season, and they're sitting there in the pew with you or maybe at a Bible study, don't expect them to be on the same page you are. Lift them up. Encourage them. Stand the gap between them and the Father as they learn and as they grow. Well, God bless. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe. If you would like to chat about this topic, I'd love to hear about it down below. I'll pray for you and enter into that discussion. God bless. We'll see you next week.